2009 has been a big year for mobile phones, but few devices have been quite so highly anticipated as the Nokia N97. As with most of the big-name handsets of the last couple of years, it's based around a large touchscreen display. In this case, it's 3.5 inches across and has a resolution of 640 by 360. However, the N97 isn't just about its touchscreen. It also features a slide-out full QWERTY keyboard, which will no doubt put off as many people as it attracts. Not least because the keyboard adds to this phone's bulk considerably, with it being 15.9mm thick for most of its length and 18mm at its thickest. It is at least slightly narrower than some of its big smartphone rivals, though. Aesthetically, this phone is frankly disappointing. Everything's just a bit cluttered and lacks finesse, and in particular, the relatively soft plastic that covers the front gives it a wobbly appearance that screams cheap. Somewhat making up for this is the fact that much of the clutter is down to class-leading features. For a start, there's the fancy camera slider that conceals a 5-megapixel camera with dual LED flashes. Opposite this is a convenient grip that, along with the matte surface of the back, makes holding the phone for picture-taking much easier than on most phones. The front also has a dedicated forward-facing camera for video calling, and a proximity sensor for turning the touchscreen off when making a call. The sides are also home to a selection of well-thought-out features. On the left, there's an easy-to-reach lock switch alongside the micro-USB data and charging socket and powerful twin speakers, while on the right is a dedicated camera button along with the volume control. Finally, up top there's a proper 3.5mm headphone jack, as well as the power button. The only thing that's missing is some form of dedicated music playback controls. Remove the back and you can access the 1500mAh battery, and underneath that is a neat tray for the SIM card. Above the battery is a microSD slot which can use to add up to another 32GB of storage to the 32 already on board. So feature-packed, the Nokia N97 certainly is. But how's it hold up in use? Well, the first thing to note is the screen is rather poor. As well as the wibbly-wobbliness mentioned earlier, there's a distracting cross-hatching pattern across the whole thing. Also, being as it uses resistive touch technology, it isn't quite as responsive as devices like the iPhone. To view, it's okay with plenty of detail and sharpness, but it's a little dull with muted colours. Also disappointing is the keyboard. While the keys feel reasonably comfortable and responsive, the lack of a dedicated row of number keys and the ridiculous spacebar placement make it less functional than it should be. Our final major complaint is to do with the operating system. It just feels clunky. Mostly this is because it just looks dated, but also things like scrolling are not particularly well handled. That said, we do quite like the wealth of features Nokia has managed to cram into the home screen. Also somewhat making up for the clunkiness is the general speed of the operating system. For the most part, it feels fast, and unlike the iPhone, it supports proper multitasking as well. The camera is another positive. Slide the lens cover down, the application loads reasonably fast. Shot-to-shot time is also acceptable, and the twin LEDs do a good job in the dark. Results are also decent, though you wouldn't know it when using the built-in photo viewer. The much-vaunted new Ovi App Store is also a very positive addition to Nokia's phones. Not only can you access and download a wealth of applications, there's also downloadable music and video content as well. Battery life also seems to be very good, with us easily getting 2 days of quite heavy usage out of our sample. So, the Nokia N97 is a very capable smartphone that's absolutely jam-packed with features. However, its poor screen, odd keyboard, sheer size and general lack of finesse means it doesn't quite get our recommendation.